the video. In this video, we show you how to work with column settings in a table and all the different features that are available. So first thing I'll do is I'll get a table. So let's bring a table. We're going to bring back from object opportunity where amount is not empty. So the amount field is not empty. And then based off that, we'll bring a couple of stuff like name, like stage, and then amount. Click apply, and then there is our data. And I'm just going to increase the size of this, and then I'll show you the column settings. So let's see if there's some data that's actually coming back. Yep, it is, looks very good. Now, one thing here is if you go on the settings, go over to column, all your columns that you actually specify will appear in here. And then one by one, if you click on the gear icon, you have tons of different options available. Let's start with include a summary row. You can, whatever column you're clicking on, you can obviously choose the different summary rows that you can bring back based off the different attributes we give you. So for example, this one, I want to bring that count, number of counts for name. So I can just add it. Now it's going to bring back the number of counts. So let's show you a quick preview. So now you can see, hopefully, it will give you the count of opportunities that are in here, which are 20. So there you go, that's the count. Let's go over to column settings here. Let's look at the second one, which is called group by. So I want to group by all the different stages of opportunities that are available. So all you do is you click on stage, click on group by. Obviously, it has to be able to group by something. So it could be a pick list. In this case, it is. And as you can see, all the different pick list values. And if I click on it, all the different opportunities that appear under that specific value. So that's group by. Let's have a look at another one. Let's do filter by. So if you want to enable filtering, now if you click it, we'll enable the filters for you, as you can see at the top. And if I click save, click preview, and we'll wait for this to load, you can see that the filters is only available on amount. It's because that's the one I chose it on. So that's something you need to be aware of, that if you want to enable it for all, you must go in here, individual columns, and check filter by. That's filter by functionality. It just simply allows you to filter based off the data in there. Some other stuff here is sort by. You can also do sort by if you wish. So let's say we uncheck group by, enable sort by, and let's click save. Let's click preview. Hopefully the grouping has now disappeared. And you can see it's now sorted by the name. So like this, and then you can click over to sort by if now the sorting is available. So let's see. Let me just re-add that in there because I don't think I've enabled it for the wrong one actually. Yeah, sorry, it was staging. So as you can see, now we have sorting by available like this. And that's all there is to it. You can enable sort by. So let's do that for the name as well. Sort by, click save, preview. And now you can see the sort by option is available, allowing you to sort alphabetically as you see fit. Next up, let's talk about include an action. Let's say I wanted to include a specific action. You can run a Salesforce action alongside it. You've got tons of different options. You can do all these predefined actions if you want. Yeah, so that's available. Text, I can allow to click on text. And then based off the click on text, I can run an action. So if I shut this off and I say click on text, now I can include an action that I can run based off. So let's just do a quick one. We'll say show message. We'll do 300 by 300. And then we'll do hello, something like that. Very simple. Apply, apply. Let's close this. Let's click save. let's click preview. And as you can see, there's the text. I'll click on it, and there you go. There's my message, hello. Okay, so you can include actions like that, and you can do it on multiple different columns as you see fit. You can have a click on icon also. So let's say I'll choose like an account icon here. So let's see what we got available. Let's use an umbrella. All right, so let's use an umbrella. Click save, click preview. And now you can see there's the umbrella, and again, it runs my action. So you can do that also. Next up, I want to talk about format. So let's say I'm bringing back a mount. I can now set different formats on how I want to bring it back. You can also prefix it with your own. So for example, let's stick to this format here. I want to show you this first. So watch the amount field now. Previously, it was just showing up with the numbers, but now it's going to show up with the dollar as a prefix and the format that I've just chosen. As you go, there you go. So that's one for you. If you obviously have a different currency, you can choose your own format and then put a prefix like I've done here, which is like the pound. And while I'm actually at it, I'll also show you the postfix. So you can just call this GBP like that. And now watch what happens. See how it's changed in the amount there. There's my pound sign, and there's GBP, the postfix, and then there is prefix. So you can also do that as well. And then finally, you've got tooltip that you can change. So I can just call this one amount, for example, and click save, click preview. And if I hover over it, my tooltip should be visible. So let's give it a second. So where is my tooltip? And you can also add tooltips for multiple columns as well. So you can go into any columns and add your tooltip as you see fit. So that's hopefully the column settings explained for you, how you can do summary row, group by, filter, sort by, include action, format, prefix, postfix, and tooltip. And yeah, that's how you do it.